Hey, what's up, people? It's been a while, huh? How do you like this political game we got going on now? Down to four little players. Well, I hate to tell the Ron Paul supporters, but he's pretty much history. Everybody pretty much figured he would be, but what can you say? You got to admit, anybody with a good message is going to get squashed in this country, no matter what direction they're coming from, whether you be a Kucinich, or you be a Ron Paul, a Gravel, or whoever. Let's face it, the media and propaganda and pure old-fashioned bullshit has a lot to do with how this country picks its leaders. With that said, you still got what they give you to play with. And as far as I'm concerned, I've been a Democrat for a long time. Actually, I'm a hell of a lot farther left than the Democrats are, but I realize small steps, grasshopper. I mean, the same discussions that's going on right now are the same discussions that was going on when I was in the service when Jimmy Carter was president. We're still trying to get the same alternative energy going, the same CAFE standards going, and get this country going in a direction of getting off the need of fossil fuel, stepping in tomorrow. But for 30 years, we've been sitting here spinning our wheels. Everything's been getting, I don't know if you could say worse, but more preppy-like. You know, you got to have your fancy car and your cappuccino and you're keeping up with this Joneses bullshit has screwed this country over in a major way. And everybody knows it. But that's the thing, though. Anytime you ever try to talk about healthcare or schools or a foreign policy of actually having diplomacy and not trying to make an arms deal or a drug deal while doing it, anytime we bring anything like that up in the past, we're called baby killers, tree huggers, dope smokers, just evil liberal in general. And that's the Democrats. But yet, even today, you can't call yourself a Democrat without actually being attacked for being a partisan. No, it's not partisan when you're right. And I hate to tell you this, but everybody on the left knew damn good and well Bush was going to war as soon as he got in office. We were having fucking pools like it was Super Bowl Sunday. Yeah, my son actually won $200. But what can you say? A lot of people seen it coming and a lot of people didn't. A lot of the people that didn't see it coming, that actually thinks that the liberals are a bunch of long-haired, dope-smoking baby killers, that's a bunch of bullshit being fed to you on purpose. And there is actually people that live in the sticks that think the people that live in the city are just straight crazy. And you don't go there at night or they'll kill you. Same people as you, just more of us, packed closer together. There isn't anything better or fancier about you because you wear a straw hat and live out in the country. In reality, I live in the country. I'm more country folk than most people would ever realize. That's what gets me with the country and western side of the equation. Ron Paul supporters. The blue-collar workers. The hard-working. I got my tools in the back of my motherfucking pickup truck. Good old boy, blue collar worker, no matter what color you are. We're all in the same boat. And I hope the Ron Paul supporters realize that and actually take a look at Barack Obama. Because since I've been gone for a bit, you know, that's been one of the reasons I've been gone. Because I actually wanted to stand behind somebody that actually had a chance. Because I always liked Kucinich. I have forever. But this country isn't ready for a Kucinich. It's barely ready for a Barack Obama. And who could make a perfect candidate? He's half white, half black. He's Christian with Muslims in his family so he can relate. He can play center on it. He hasn't been around long enough for them to get him fucking blackmailed to the fucking hilt to where he fucking owes them anything. He still might have a few favors out there, but his history doesn't go as deep as Clinton's, that's for damn sure. And old Chili Willy Bill Clinton being involved in uranium mining? while getting kickbacks doing shady deals in this administration, wanting to go to war with Iran over nuclear enrichment. Now, that's one thing that even at least Hillary on the left does separate the difference between Iran's right to have nuclear power and enrich their own uranium. I don't know if she'll go that far. Now, there's the dilemma, enrich your own uranium. But without talking to them, you're not going to make anything any better anyway. And Hillary's already come out and said that, no, that the president of the United States doesn't talk to Ahmadinejad, or however how you say his name. Not up front anyway. We send our people to go talk to him. Well, that's coming off like your shit don't fucking stink and I don't talk to leaders to other fucking countries because I'm the badass motherfucker in the United States and you do what you're told. That type of attitude just doesn't cut it. That's another reason why I like Barack Obama. Just like he said in not one of his speeches I heard not too long ago where he was addressing that problem right there. Where he said, everybody says don't talk to foreign leaders. No, everybody says talk to foreign leaders that knows anything about anything. Yeah, people said he isn't. You can't do that. He said, "Watch me." That's what we need. We need that type of fucking attitude in the Democratic Party. And either that, it's just straight this way: Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, or you motherfuckers can be stuck with McCain. Now, if you want to be white trash enough to be stuck with McCain, then you get what you deserve. The rest of you, with common sense, take a good look at the game and make sure you pay attention to what's going on in your own backyard, and we'll all live a hell of a lot better off. Y'all take it easy. Later!